Good morning to you.
Good morning.
I want to welcome anyone who is attending for the first time on a Sunday morning. We open our facility here on Sunday to share ideas with you that you can use to improve the quality of your lives, drawing upon philosophy, psychology, religion, parapsychology, mysticism, anything that we can use to understand ourselves and what is taking place around us. And now I'd like for you to sit back in your chairs, and we'll take a few moments to work upon the health of our bodies. If you would you let your eyes close and just think along with me for a few moments. I turn inward to that great power that created me, the power that is the life force of the universe. That power exists in me right here and right now. It has created this outer body. It has created all of the intricacies of the functions of my body. And so I open myself to the intelligence of that power, for that power knows exactly what my body needs to maintain good health or to restore it. And according to whatever my physical need might be, I open the consciousness of all of the millions of cells of my body, from the crown of my head down the length of my body to the soles of my feet, to that indwelling presence, a presence that is light within me and yet light everywhere. The embodiment, the first manifestation of God's presence, manifesting as light, and that light contains within it the perfect blueprint for the health, maintaining, and healing of my body. And so I feel now that light, it is within me on a spiritual Christ God level, is entering into the nucleus of every one of the millions of cells of my body, regenerating, restoring, renewing, healing each and every one of the energy factors in each and every one of the cells of my body, so that right here, right now, in the eternal now, my body and its energy field is in a state of divine polarity and equilibrium, a state of harmony, and that whatever has been out of balance is now back in balance. And thus I feel a harmony with all of nature, the beauty of nature. And that beauty vibrates throughout me, healing me, caressing my soul in gentleness, in wholeness, in love. I feel an internal blessing. Of the beyond within. And I am left in a state of divine rapture throughout my body, at peace, so very whole and complete. In health, in wholeness, perfection that is God and Spirit reflects through my body. Its light, its presence, its love. And so now let me begin to open my eyes and my senses to the exterior world, maintaining that health energy, that health vibration that exists here within me. This morning's subject deals with your mind's energy frequencies for success. I want you to think about that, your mind's energy frequencies for success. In metaphysical and mystical studies, we often refer to thought as being energy and energy as being thought. But let's take it this morning one step beyond. Let's say that if you have a composite of thoughts or a grouping of thoughts, that those thoughts can exist on a certain frequency. Let's, as an example, suppose that you have a radio station or a television station. Taking the radio station, maybe one station plays jazz, another one plays classical, another one plays whatever else type of music. And if you tune them in and you listen to the music for a period of time, while the music has many notes which could be interpreted as thoughts, if you put all of these notes together, they will form a frequency. In order to be able to get to this particular station, you have to get into a frequency of energy as you tune into it. The same situation takes place throughout our lives. We may have groupings of thoughts. A person may think about being successful, but until they feel the energy and are tuned into the frequency of this, then they're just merely thinking about it. I have found that people that succeed in whatever they're succeeding in are in what we call, what the athlete calls, the zone. In other words, as an example, if you have a baseball pitcher and the pitcher is pitching a magnificent game, they're in a zone. That's what the sports commentator will call it. Or perhaps a quarterback on a football field having a wonderful day passing. Everything is just directly pinpointed. It's in a particular zone. Or a comedian that's up on a stage, cracking one joke after another, and every joke is just taking off, and it's building and building and building and building and building, till the audience simply can't get enough. They don't want the person to leave the stage, because the person is in a frequency energy zone. A person who mimics other people, a Rich Little as an example, a person who gets up on a stage and pretends to be other people. Sometimes you can actually see the face resembling the person that they're imitating. Any of you ever noticed this? Why? Because we're a psychophysical unit. The mind affects the body affects the mind. And so it is that the energy inside of any one of us can take over. The very same thing when we're experiencing an emotion, as an example. Whether we're happy or sad, the face adjusts to it. But we could take on an entire different personality, and the face would adjust to it. We see a person who is depressed, as an example, and they're walking down the street and just shuffling along, and Or we see a person who's successful. We see them standing erect. We see their posture upright. We see them with an air. We call it an air of confidence. But what is an air of confidence? It's the energy that that person is giving off. We see a physician with a good bedside manner who almost heals the person just by showing up at their bedside because their manner is so reassuring, the energy that they're giving off. So we tune into different frequencies. As an example, when I was a child, we used to go to the movies. It was pre-television days, and I remember that as small children, maybe we would go to see some movie on a Saturday afternoon where there was a superhero, and as the kids left the movie, everyone would become that superhero. They'd want to run home and throw on a cape and pretend they could fly or whatever else, because they got into the energy. They were in that energy field. People get into a particular type of energy. The energy is a winner or it is a loser. You can have two people, as an example, that are waking up in the morning. One is a successful person, the other one is anything but successful. After they clear the cobwebs from their mind, from their eyes, and they start to get up, the energy, the basic energy that drives this person will take over. On one, it will be depression. They can barely get their body out of bed. The other one, they know if they get their body out of bed and get going, that it's going to be an interesting day. It isn't a day that may not be filled with certain problems, certain difficulties, and so forth, but they know that there's going to be something going on. Because the energy kicks in. The success frequency kicks in. Where does the success frequency come from? It comes from the divine within ourselves. Now, you can pussyfoot around in life, and you can say to yourself, I'm going to go to all of these prosperity seminars. I've known people that go to prosperity seminars one after the other, and are still as poor and erotic as when they took the first one. What happens? They go in and they get all charged up. It's like a multi-level meeting where people go in to sell some multi-level product. And the person that's doing the talking gets them all worked up into a feverish pitch. So to be able to send them out to have an excuse to sell something to get this multi-level type of thing moving. But it wears off. It's the same thing when people will go to church on a Sunday morning and all of the organs and the music will play and blast and all of the things, all of the singing and so on. And they'll feel good and they'll feel pumped up. They're in a particular energy, but the energy isn't lasting. And that's the thing. Always think in terms of that which is lasting. Always think in terms of that which is consistent. Losers who are on a losing frequency don't think along those terms. They think about only the present, only what's right exactly in front of them. But to be on a success frequency, you have to think about what's not only in front of you, but what's way down at the other end of the road. How do you get into this kind of state of mind? Well, God created a universe. A divine intelligence, however you choose to call or think about God, created a universe, created this physical body, manifests itself through this physical body. The closer we come to the creative presence within ourselves, the closer we come to the ultimate success frequency of the universe, meaning let's create a planet. Let's create a life form. Let's create this. Let's create a building. Let's create an enterprise. We begin to think in larger terms. We begin to see things in a larger picture. And as you become successful, you are more and more tapping into, in essence, whether you consciously realize it or not. Now, there are many people that are atheists that are very successful in an earthly and a monetary type of way. And this is an unconscious type of thing. They've hit into one particular frequency that deals with monetary and material frequency within the mind of the universe. What I'm suggesting here is that there is an ultimate frequency that equals success, and that this ultimate frequency takes into consideration that success is not just monetary or earthly. Monetary or earthly gain in and of itself is not where it's at. Now, to be successful really means to live the life that God created you for. To live your soul's purpose. That's the ultimate real success of life. Whether that means that you have $1,000 in the bank or $1 trillion in the bank, it makes no difference. Are you living the life you're supposed to be living? If you're living the life you're supposed to be living, you're happy. In other words, how do you know that you're living the life that you're supposed to? Are you happy? Simple as that. Some people want notoriety, they want fame, they want power, they want to be noticed. Other people want to be just totally left alone. They don't want that. Each is right in their own particular way because each serves to create the composite of the whole tapestry that we call life. Now let's take a look at the affirmations and see how these tie in with what I've been talking about. The first one says defining success. It says, I recognize that success, spiritually understood, means success of my life as a whole and is not limited to material or worldly definitions of success. Notice that. It isn't limited to worldly definitions. There's a lot more to living a successful life than a person's bank account or a person's portfolio. It's again measured by, are you happy when you wake up in the morning? Do you feel a sense of fulfillment? Are you content with you, your life, the way you're living each day? That to me is a successful person. Whether they have material things or they don't have material things. Whether they're married or they're single, whether anybody knows that they even exist or doesn't exist, as long as you feel that sense of fulfillment and happiness within yourself when you awaken and you're going through your day and you are in a state of contentment, fine. The next says thought energy. I understand that every thought I think is an energy, and that certain like energies exist in certain frequencies within my mind. You get into a success frequency within your mind. Remember now, you're actually tapping into a portion of universal mind or consciousness, divine consciousness. And as you do this, there's a success frequency that you get on, and that success frequency will equal what your soul's purpose is. In other words, if you're supposed to succeed as an athlete, you'll succeed as an athlete. An artist, you'll succeed as an artist. As an entrepreneur, you'll succeed as an entrepreneur. Whatever it is that you're supposed to succeed in, when you tune in to what God's frequency of success is for you, not for me, not for the person sitting next to you, but for you, and then you live it, You are it. You don't think about it. You are it. A person who sits around thinking about success is not successful. A person who is living success is successful. A person who is living success doesn't have enough time to sit around and contemplate what they are or are not. They're too busy doing and being successful. Success frequencies. I understand that there are various success frequencies, such as financial success, and success in love, success in many, many different areas. Again, according to your soul's purpose. Everybody is on a different wavelength because each of us are here for different purposes. None of us are here for the same thing. We would bore each other silly. There would be no reason for us to even exist in isolated bodies apart from each other and apart from existing as one infinite field of light. So the infinite field of light gives the illusion of separateness. It gives the illusion of I, thou. It gives the illusion that you're one thing, I'm something else, and somebody else down the street is still something else again. It creates this illusion, this house of cosmic mirrors, as it were. But as you begin to see through the glass darkly, you begin to see then that everything basically is an illusion, and that if you step out of the illusion, you are really stepping into your own mind where a reality exists and you can see the whole picture. Then you cuddle up to this success frequency inside of your mind. The closer you get to God within you that knows why God created your body, your personality, your individuality, the closer you are to stepping into that success frequency, which is your soul's purpose. Now, I know this is a little abstract, but if you see the way the world is living itself day by day, that to me is abstract, because abstract would possibly cause confusion, delusion, neurosis, and basically a psychotic type of situation in which the unconscious is overwhelming the conscious mind with all types of primal base energies today. That's why we see the anger, the crime rate, the urge to war, the things that are going on in vile ways throughout our society. Tuning in, I understand that success is achieved by consciously or unconsciously karma. In other words, a person may come into this life, never come into contact with anything that I'm talking about here, and still unconsciously be motivated by that success frequency within themselves, because it's a part of what is their nature. Maybe they did a lot of good deeds in a previous life, and suddenly they're here they are in this life and they're becoming a rousing success, and yet they've never studied, they've never meditated, and it just seems that success is automatic to them. It's like the old idea of the concept that whatever the person touches turns to gold. Universal God Mind, I understand that all success frequencies exist and come from Universal Mind or God, which is at the innermost center of consciousness within me. Now that's what I've been alluding to right along. Where does the success frequency come from? It's a law of physics, something can't come from nothing. If you are on a success frequency, consciously or unconsciously, there is a reason for it. Nothing in this universe is by coincidence, including you. Including you. You're not just some happened freak chance of nature. You are here because the universe is alive and well in you. That universe is the spirit, of the infinite, the eternal. It's infinite intelligence. It's been around through eternity, and it's had a lot of time to work on itself and get things perfect. Think about that. If you've been around through eternity, you've had an awful lot of time to self-develop and to develop thoughts, to develop energies, to develop beings, to develop planets, to develop stars, to develop everything that we can conceive of in the human consciousness. So I understand that all success frequencies exist and come from universal mind or God, which is at the innermost center of consciousness within me. And that is within you. And you, and you, and you. It's within everyone. What do you want to accept? An ego, a personal ego, a self-pride? It's good to feel good about yourself, but feel good about yourself because of the God that's inside of you, but the universe is inside of you. The moment you get all pumped up, somebody's going to let the air out of your tire. It's going to happen. You know it. And if you've lived a few years of life, you know that the air has been left out and your personal ego has gone flat a few times. So why cuddle up to this thing, this inevitable flat tire of life? It makes no sense. Anchor yourself from within yourself on that which is unchanging, that which is eternal. And if you're going to think about success and you get into the for success frequency of that which is lasting, consistent, then you ride the crest and the wave through lifetime after lifetime existence, whether it's physical, celestial, what have you, wherever you are, whatever you're doing, you are the manifestation. Let your light so shine before men that they may see your good works and glorify your Father which is in heaven. So, you do the good works, you're successful. People say, hey, wow, you really have it on the ball. And you say, I am that which I am. Credit goes not to me, but credit goes to the same spirit and mind of universal consciousness which is in you. And they walk away, what the hell did he say? Whatever it was, it sounded impressive. Meditation. Through my daily practice of meditation, I receive success frequencies into my conscious mind, originating from the God mind within me. You start an enterprise. First, God puts that idea into the conscious forefront of your mind, and then God puts the accompanying actors and actresses or thoughts, the supporting cast of thoughts into your mind. And you have this tremendous drama, stage play, whatever you care to describe it or think about it. And suddenly you're off and running. You've tuned into the success frequency in your mind, whatever it is that you're doing in your life. Those that succeed are on a success frequency. If you've been around any people or persons or even one person who seems to you to be successful by whatever measure of success that you believe that that person is achieving, notice that they seem to be in some kind of a zone. Any of you ever noticed this? Anybody, or am I up here isolated from the rest of the universe? I certainly have. It's a whole, as I said a few minutes ago, it's a whole air, whether you want to call it an auric energy, whatever you want to call it, makes no difference, however you wish to describe it. There is an energy. It's an energy of acceptance of success. It is an energy that says this person is successful. You could have maybe a dozen people walk up on a stage, and a person that is really successful, you'll know which person it was that stepped on that stage. Not because they come up like this, because that could be only an actor. But there is a calm self-assurance because the success energy is coming from the ultimate calmness or serenity of the universe within the person themselves. That's what we call ultimate self-confidence. It's not anything that's manufactured. It's innate, and it's innate inside of you. I want each and every one of you to think of yourselves in this way, that whatever I'm suggesting that anybody else has accomplished, whatever success anybody has had, don't think that I'm talking about somebody else. Everything that I'm saying is about you. It's all about you and you and you and you. I'm just reflecting back to you what you, deep down inside, already know about you. Now, what do you want to accept? Misery or happiness? You know, there's a drama, masks for entertainment, the frown and the smile. I prefer the smile. I prefer the laughter. I prefer the humor. You prefer whatever it is that you prefer. The choice is yours because the God power inside of you has given you the choice. Whenever I look at a person, I see a great amount of potential. Whoever I look at, I realize that they still haven't reached their full potential. No matter what they've accomplished already, they haven't reached their full potential. And that's exciting. Go stand in front of a mirror and say to yourself, "Hey there, you." You haven't reached your full potential. Well, I did that this a few days ago, and I did this over there. And, No, you still haven't reached it. Because it's unlimited. Not just as a philosophical word to massage you, to make you feel good, to call you unlimited. You are unlimited. You are unlimited because you're not you. You're pretending to be you, Mary, Frank, John, Harry, but in truth, you are the universe having taken image, shape, form, and embodiment. Yeah. So in that sense, you're unlimited. So when we talk about success, what are we measuring? Years ago when I was growing up, when somebody said, "That person's a millionaire," wow, you almost said it in hushed, reverent tones, "A millionaire." Now, unless they have billions, you don't even take another millionaire. So what? Good God, I got a house that's worth that. Yeah. So where is this thing? Where does it begin? Where does it end? It begins and it ends within you, and where it never ends is on the unlimited resource that each and every one of you have, if you start using it and don't start just going and becoming a seminar prosperity junkie. If you will ever stop and actually use what it is that you have inside of you, you don't need anything else. You don't need anybody telling you what you have. You are what you are. The famous words, "I am." The words of God coming through you, "I am. I am that which I am. I am the success energy. I am the success frequency. I am the success power. I am creative. Why accept less? How do we get in touch with that frequency if it's not already working through you? Meditation. Through my daily practice of meditation, I receive success frequencies into my conscious mind, originating from the God mind within me. Success frequencies. I have lived on success frequencies all my adult life. When things go down, I just go into another success frequency. It gives me and it provides me with creative intelligence, creative ideas, creative thoughts, and so forth, in which I come up through the God presence within me with some absolutely brilliant idea, and that brilliant idea turns over and it manufactures money. Come on, let's be real. But if I just keep going around and listening and listening and listening to everybody else but not listening to the God inside of me, it's going to be another lifetime of seminars. I've taught these seminars. I know that if I start a seminar and I have 100 people in front of me, I know from experience that maybe 3 might make it. Not a very high percentage. Either I'm an awfully bad teacher, or the students aren't ready. They haven't had enough misery yet. Now I'm asking you, have you had enough misery? You know, have you had enough misery? Have you hit your head against the wailing wall long enough and hard enough that you've drawn enough psychic blood and so forth that your guts are spilled all over and you say, I'm madder than hell and I'm not going to take it anymore, and that's it?
Yeah.
God, I'm getting an amen over here. An unsolicited one. That's coming from the heart, boy, when they get spontaneous like that. Visualization. Periodically, during my daily activities, I visualize or imagine my body as filled with God's creative light energy, filling my conscious awareness with success energy frequencies. Okay, there are so many books that are written on visualization. You visualize the car, you visualize the home, you visualize the tall, dark stranger. You visualize all of these things. And all of these things are foolish things. Why are they foolish things, you say? Oh, I need that tall, dark, handsome stranger in my life. I need that certain kind of car. I need that certain kind of home. Only God knows what you really need. And so when you visualize, just imagine you're on a spiritual level, the interior region of your body is filled with light. That's on a spiritual level. Obviously, on a physiological level, you've got all of the different anatomical parts of your body, but I'm talking on a spiritual level, you're filled with light. And from that light, as the Bible says, and from light all things came forth. That means that the frequency that equals success is within that light. So you close your eyes and you think to yourself, you mentally image, imagine, visualize that the whole of your body is like a hollow filled with light, and that in that light are all of the various frequencies that comprise the entirety of the universe. And that you are drawing upon the success frequency inside of that field of light that equals the soul's purpose for which you were created in this lifetime. You mentally imagine that this is coming up into your head area. Which brings us then to our final affirmation and ties this together as a practice. It says sensitivity attunement. periodically during the day to keep attuned to success energy frequencies. With one hand, I touch the upper part of my body containing creative light energy success frequencies, and with the forefinger of my other hand, touch my forehead, signifying that success frequencies are flowing into and influencing my conscious mind. This is purely a sensitivity technique. Just put one hand on your heart as an example, and then put the other hand up on your forehead. Just put the finger up here. It's a thing just to keep us centered. In essence, there is a movement here by just putting one hand, as it were, on one part and the other. I'm going to put this mic aside just for demonstration purpose. Because each one of your fingers is a field of energy. Your upper body is a field of energy. Your head area, obviously, is quite a field of energy. And so, in a sensitivity body placement, you are helping to keep yourself attuned to this flow. If you do that, success will follow. Don't try to say what success is going to be in your life. Now, there's a school of stupid thought, as I call it. The school of stupid thought says, you've got to concentrate on what it is that you want. Man plans, God laughs. Do you ever hear that expression? Man plans, God laughs. Have you ever heard it? Whoever came forth with it, it came forth from the God within that person. Because we go with the flow of why we were created. And if you're in that flow, then everything else takes care of itself. Beyond that, every type of self-help type of situation that you encounter is just killing time. As Schweitzer said, and I've quoted this time and again because it applies so many times, the position of the physician is to amuse the patient long enough till the natural healing energy does the healing. The position of the seminar leader is to amuse the seminar attendee long enough until the real reality kicks in. How many of you follow this line of thinking? I'm just curious here, okay? And that isn't what people want to hear. Because you have the feeling, the human mind and personality is so gullible that it feels that if I'm doing something, something is happening. I'm sure that the hamster on the wheel feels the same way. Now, let's sit back in our chairs. Close our eyes and spend a few moments tuning in to that presence that is within us. I turn away from the outer world for a few moments. I turn my mind in upon itself. I reverse my outer senses and turn them inward upon myself, so that I begin to move into the consciousness of my own mind. I step away from the outer world to step into the inner world within myself, a world of mind, a world of endless awareness. An infinite world without beginning and without ending. For that is the nature of consciousness within myself. An Alpha and an Omega. without beginning, without ending. Endless, endless am I. For I have always been and will always be. It is a matter now to become self-conscious and self-knowing of my reality. That I was long before this body was, and I will be long after this body is no more. That I am part of an eternal presence in whom I move and I live and I have physical beingness as a thought form within the mind of the eternal. And as I am inseparable from the eternal, a thought within the mind of the eternal, so I am in a state of perpetual eternal oneness with that state of consciousness in which I exist. And that I have clothed myself through the God presence within and surrounding me with a body that I call my physical body and a conscious mind that I call my personality. And yet while I am these things, I am neither of these things because these are temporary things. Yet they exist for a purpose and the purpose is God's purpose, which thus is my soul's purpose for existing. And I tune in to my soul's purpose, which is the success frequency for my life. The success energy frequency for my life is what I tune into and I'm one with. This moment and every moment of my life, in my wakefulness and in my sleep, in my coming and in my going, within this life, beyond this life. I sit quietly for a few moments to feel and sense a higher reality that exists within me and is a part of me. The reality that created me lives within me, manifests outwardly as me. In a few moments now, I'll begin to open my eyes ever so slowly. And as I open my eyes and my senses to the exterior world once again, I'll stretch my arms and my hands over my head in a symbolic gesture of always reaching for something higher in my life, knowing that that something higher that I reach for is to be found in the height of who and what I truly am within myself, a living, breathing manifestation of the stars and of the heavens, of universal life and mind, having taken image, shape, form, and embodiment. And I bring down my hands now, resting in the peace and the security that this is so, and so it is.